The V-2, the infamous German wonder weapon, developed during World War II. It was the first long-range ballistic missile, and it was mainly used to attack Allied cities. It was a design of Werner von Braun, whose work was already noticed by the Wehrmacht in the 1930s. The original army designation of the weapon was A4, as Aggregat 4, but it received the name V-2, standing for Vengeance Weapon 2 in German, from the Nazi propaganda ministry. Each V-2 was 14 meters long, weighed about 13 tons, and could deliver a 900 kg warhead. Their average range was around 320 km, and they could reach 80 km of altitude during the flight. The first successful test flight of the V-2 took place on the 3rd of October 1942, and it reached an altitude of 84 km. This was followed by hundreds of flights during the years, as the German scientists worked out the weapon's teething problems. In December 1942, the V-2 was already ordered in mass production, as it was expected the weapon's technical issues will be all worked out by the summer of 1943. In reality, though, many issues were still unresolved by autumn of that year. The V-2 production line was nearly ready for mass production when RAF bombers attacked the test site during Operation Hydra in August 1943. This could only happen thanks to an Austrian resistance group, including Heinrich Meyer, a Catholic priest. They managed to send the drawings of the V-2 rockets and the locations of the manufacturing sites to the Allies. The attack delayed further tests by about 2 months and then forced the Germans to move the unfinished production plant underground. The Germans had a hard time funding the V-2 project, as it consumed huge amount of materials and resources. Some sources say that the full cost of the German rocket project was more than what the US spent on the Manhattan project that produced the atomic bomb. The alcohol for its fuel needed about 30 tons of potatoes to be distilled for one launch, which was a huge problem in Germany, where food was scarce by the end of the war. In August 1944, Hitler ordered the V-2 attacks to begin. The first launches against Allied targets occurred on September 7th with two V-2s aimed at Paris, but both of the rockets crashed soon after launch. The second day, another attack on Paris caused some damage, and two rockets launched at London also reached their target. In the following months, almost 3,200 rockets were fired at various Allied targets. Around 1,400 at the UK, 76 at France, and more than 1,600 at Belgium, where the port city of Antwerp was their main target, resulting in a large number of deaths. The Allied forces managed to capture two of the rockets in 1944. In May, one relatively intact rocket was recovered by the Polish resistance after a test launch. It fell in a swampy area, and they managed to get to the crash site before the Germans. Another one landed in Sweden instead of falling into the sea by a control malfunction in June. That one was recovered too, and also made its way to England. Unlike the earlier V-1 buzz bomb, the V-2 travelled faster than the speed of sound, so there was no warning for the people, and there was no effective defence against these weapons. The V-1 could be intercepted by fighter planes or shot down by anti-aircraft batteries, but the V-2 was too fast, and it arrived from above instead of level flight. The most effective countermeasure was to feed false intelligence to the Germans. The British deliberately leaked false reports showing the rockets were overshooting London by miles. The plan worked, as the Germans adjusted their aiming according to the reports, and as a result, more than half the V-2s landed outside London. The first use of V-2 rockets against a tactical target came close to the end of the war, and it was also their first German target when the US Army captured the Ludendorff Bridge. During the Battle of Remagen, the Germans launched 11 V-2 rockets at the bridge, desperate to destroy it, but the attack was unsuccessful. Some rockets landed close to the bridge, but some missed their targets by miles. Some even struck the town of Remagen, killing several US soldiers. After the war, Allied nations raced to get their hands on as many V-2 rockets and rocket scientists as possible. A big amount of V-2 rockets and parts were captured by the US, together with more than 100 designers, including Werner von Braun. An Allied test, Operation Backfire, took place in Germany in October 1945, when three of the V-2s were test-fired by Allies from their original launch site. In post-war years, all Allied nations tested the V-2 rockets extensively. The US Army was no exception. They conducted a lot of rocket launches, and the first ever photo of Earth from space was taken from a V-2 rocket launched by the US Army in October 1946. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and in the comments let me know if there's any interesting events or vehicles you'd like to see.